Hey, it's Justin. One question I get all the time as we're building reports and creating reports for clients is how to provide information in a way that is really understandable to the client. I mean, it's great that we understand this stuff, but how do we know what they understand? And I think the thing that's helped me enormously is what I call affectionately call the knowledge pyramid. There was an exec at Walmart that I was working with at one point, and he sat me down. We were visiting about this subject of information, and he enlightened me on this knowledge pyramid. Or he might have called it wisdom pyramid. Either way, it's this pyramid where you have all these different levels, and I'll kind of show a picture of it. You have these different levels of information and providing information. And on the bottom, we have the data, raw data, visualized data. And then one step up from that, we have information. One step up from that, we have knowledge. And one step up from that, we have wisdom. And he explained it with this anecdote. He said, pretend you and I are driving down the road, and we're driving in a city that we've never been in. And he said, I'm your navigator and you're the driver. And he said, I'm trying to tell you that up ahead there's a red light. And he said, if I tell you in the data level, I'm going to tell you with the IP address of the light on the computer network. I'm going to tell you with the GPS coordinates so that you can map it with a GPS so you can know exactly where that light is. I'm going to tell you the binary on-off of each of the lights on there, indicating that, you know, there's one that's on and that there's the others that are off, that you know, that it would be the red that was on. But I'm going to tell you the binary of all that, and that's how I'm going to try to describe that. And the question is, can you interpret that? And the answer is, of course. Yes, definitely that's interpretable. It just takes a whole bunch of time and it takes a whole bunch of calories, brain calories, for me to interpret that kind of information. He said, if I take it up a level and we take it up to the information level, he says, I'm going to tell you that on the corner of 5th and Main, there's a red light. And now you're thinking, as the driver, you're thinking, okay, where the heck is 5th and Main? Never heard of that before in my life. I've never been to this city before. What's the relevance of there being a red light? I'm assuming there's relevance. I don't have any context here. I don't know where I'm at. So therefore, I don't know where 5th and Main is relative to me. And he said, okay, so that's not going to have any value to you either. It may if you know where 5th and Main is. But if you don't, then we got a problem. He said, if I take it up one more level and we go up to the knowledge level. Now at the knowledge level, we're dealing with something a little bit different. Knowledge adds context. Context is critical. And we're going to listen with our reporting ears for a second here, because context is absolutely imperative in reporting. It's providing the understanding of where the person is relative to where the thing that you're describing is. In a business world, it's describing where we are, how we're performing as a business financially, and the impending doom or positive things, you know, that may be coming up. We have to be able to recognize and see those things coming, good or bad, and we also know exactly where we are relative to those things. Otherwise, we don't have any context. So if I was to give it on the knowledge level, I would say ahead, or if he was to give it rather, he would say ahead, there is a red light. So now I have context. I know that up ahead on the road that I'm traveling on, there's a red light. If we take it up one more level, what we're doing is something very, very powerful and interpretable. And that is by saying, there's a red light ahead, therefore you need to hit the brakes now. Now, what we're doing at that level is we're providing an assessment. We're assessing what needs to be done based on the information that's provided. The goal is not necessarily for us to always live in the wisdom level, because it's very hard for us to know all, as a financial advisor, for us to know all of the financial details or all of the details that enable that decision to be made. That decision needs to be ultimately made by the CEO or the manager or whomever, the department head, whatever. So anytime we can live in the information at a minimum, but in the knowledge level, that's when we're able to provide information that really has context for our clients and really provides actionable intelligence, because now they have context. They know where they're at relative to that thing, and they're able to make a decision based off of that. So that's just a little bit about the knowledge pyramid.